stopping by. You guys, I guess you're used to this by now, because I keep telling people you guys play the most entertaining games in the league. It's night after night that stuff like this happens with you. How much fun has this season been?
Man, I appreciate you guys having me. It's been amazing. You know, we got a great collective group of guys, you know, that are, you know, coming together. You know, we know it's going to take all of us to get to where we are today. And we know it's going to take all of us to get wins in this league. It's hard to win in this league, so we know what it takes.
D'Angelo, this is 2 weeks in a row now. I got a chance to talk to you after one of these games, man. Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Is it becoming a thing, too, where the muscle memory for this entire group is now that we can finish games and we can get through these late game situations because you've been through so many of them this year?
Right. Correct. We've, man, honestly, I've been through it my whole career. On the other end of the tail end of games like that, you know, but I've learned from them, you know, and I think we got a great veteran group of guys as well that is appreciating being on the other end. We got guys that have been on it throughout their career, winning those type of games. So it feels good to get that.
D'Angelo, Sean Marks and Coach Atkinson seem like they've really tried to build a culture there where everybody understands that you're going to be bigger than the individual parts, that everybody's going to be willing to sacrifice for one another. And when you guys lost Caris LeVert, I think we've seen you do that, and you've been rallying around one another.
Yeah. Like I said, we know it's going to be we as a group to get it done. No individual. Tonight it was my night. The night before it was Spencer, the night before Joe Harris. Like we got a great group of guys that confidence is throughout the roof, and coach is preaching it. You know, we're playing for one another, and we wanna see each other do well.
Oh, D, I keep calling you guys America's team because you're just that entertaining. So congratulations on entertaining America again tonight and for getting above 500 for the first time this season. We appreciate you stopping by.
Heck yeah, man. Appreciate you guys.
All right, D'Angelo Russell with us after a 40-point night and another comeback win for the Brooklyn Nets, who it's been, 4 years since they made the playoffs. I keep mentioning this purgatory period they ran because of the trade that set them back for years. They just had no assets. They couldn't do anything. You got all these guys that they were either taking chances on or trading for different circumstances, who felt like maybe their other team had given up on them, and here they are in the position to make the postseason.
I remember having a conversation with somebody a couple years ago, though. Kenny Atkinson instilled a certain fight in this group and established a certain kind of culture so that when they got to this point, Griff, they would have the wherewithal to mm-hmm. battle this way. And they were going around the league a couple years ago, getting their noses bloodied,
yep.
but scrapping. And to me, that says something when you build it like that. They didn't take any shortcuts. They didn't try and, you know, circumvent the process here. And nobody talked about what they're going through in the same manner, because you didn't have a Joel Embiid or some kind of superstar to hang your rebuild on. But what they've done is instituted a culture change for the Brooklyn Nets that I think is something that's lasting. This is something you can see going on for years to come as they continue to evolve and get better. A lot of these different young guys playing together, growing together, and figuring it out as a group.
Yeah, they only won 28 games last year, but you've seen over the last couple of years, they had a defined style, and they always played hard, no matter who was on the floor and what the talent level was.
Well, and to a huge degree, that's by design on the part of Sean Marks and Kenny Atkinson. And it also is in part because there's no one they had to play.
Right.
They could build a culture of accountability, because if you don't do the right things, you don't get on the floor for Kenny Atkinson. And that's a really good thing when you're in a situation where you can reward people that are modeling the behavior and the effort that you want as a coach. It's very complicated to grow a young team when there are people who are, quote, entitled to their minutes. In Brooklyn, it's been accountability from the very beginning. It was in Boston when Brad Stevens first got there, and now Boston has overlaid that elite talent, and you saw they came into the year with very high expectations. This Brooklyn team has room for potentially two max free agents this offseason, and I really believe the culture that they have built is going to speak to the right free agent at the right time.
Sure, the rest of the league has seen how they've gone about this, and these guys have played against them. They know how they play. They play hard. Look, Brooklyn's not a bad place to live. It's a beautiful arena. They got a lot going for them there as well. All right, much more coming up.